CGM.
Oh.
CGM is a new and amazing technology. And as any technology, it has its use cases and its limitations. But is it for you? I've just finished reading the latest Metabolic Health report, and it turned out to be even worse than I thought. We'll get back to it in a minute or two. But that's why I wanted to highlight who might benefit from using this device, even briefly, and who wouldn't, because CGM has a direct relationship to the metabolic disaster we are living through and the dropping of life expectancy. Also, just from my own experience, until I've started to use it, I was completely wrong about my own health. Well, maybe not wrong, more like just lying to myself. CGM stands for Continuous Glucose Monitor and operates like a mosquito. It has a tiny filament, I don't know if you can see it or not, which gets under your skin, but instead of blood, it samples interstitial fluid. Also, unlike mosquitoes, who are the deadliest animal on Earth, yes, counting humans, CGM has potential to be one of the trivial daily gadgets to save quite a few lives, or at least human years. The disclaimer here is, it's one of my top three gadgets which have completely changed me from a couch potato to exercising every day. So I'm biased. But if you're like me and want to live to be 100 years young or more by design, let's keep talking. Now, this comment, please don't put CGM on your body if you are not diabetic, is a little bit black and white. And as you can guess, I disagree. And it's not just me, but also the leading longevity doctors and scientists and even Garmin, who calls it sports biosensor. Why? Because saying that only diabetics should use CGM is like saying that only insomniacs should track their sleep or only morbidly obese should track their calories. That kind of aligns with the current Western medicine, do nothing until you have an official diagnostic code. But sorry, I have different approach. On this channel, I prefer to put the helmet on before I have a concussion. Then again, if this approach is not for you, I totally understand. Not everyone is data-driven, and CGM provides you with a ton of data. Your personal energetic response to the foods you eat, and it also reflects on your muscle mass, and how stressed you are, and how solid is your sleep, and how good your overall metabolic health. Which can be overwhelming and triggering, especially if you have some OCD type or have ED history. Then you should probably stay away, because mental health is always the first priority, because like what's the point to live to be 100 if you're miserable all the time? On the other hand, if you're the kind of person who thinks that knowledge times action equals power, then CGM is an invaluable tool to stay on top of the insulin sensitivity, because insulin plays a part and underlines almost every modern ailment, and that's heart disease, cancer, dementia, diabetes, our happy three friends. And we're not even talking about direct harm of the high blood sugar to the cardiovascular system and collagen glycation, which drives inflammation aging. That's the cutting edge research for longevity enthusiasts. But just for the general population, me and you, dynamic blood sugar response provided by CGM is an amazing aggregate and actionable AAA score for metabolic health. Which brings us back to that report. Back in 2019, it was estimated that only 12% of Americans are metabolically healthy. And guess what? In 2022, the number is down to 6.8. So when I did an honest assessment on myself a couple years ago, I wasn't in that number, but today I am. And this tiny guy was instrumental in my recovery. You can only improve what you measure, and that is the measurement I was missing. As my own devil's advocate, I can try to argue here that CGM is actually no better than combination of the scales, measuring tape, and A1C blood test. But you see, it wasn't enough for me. If they work for you and you are in that 6.8 of the metabolically healthy, great. But if you are not, you can try CGM as I did for a few weeks and see. Because CGM acts as a canary in the coal mine and gives you a very unique opportunity to stack the deck in your favor and change the collision course. And the sooner you start, the easier it gets to avoid the disaster. So, if you want to learn more about how to get this monitor relatively cheap, what brands are out there, how to install it safely for the first time, I have a whole dedicated guide for you right here. Living smart, aging is bad. So, see you there.